وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
How do we keep ties with family members who dislike seeing others do well and succeed? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salam ala abdillahi wa rasulih nabiyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. So first of all, we say that it's not necessary to tell everyone all of the good that happens to you. Some people misunderstand the ayah wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith as meaning that every time something good happens to you, you need to tell the entire world about it. That's not the case, and that's not the majority of the scholars of tafsir. They didn't see the ayah like that. In fact, you can generally see that the opinions of tafsir around this ayah, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ, don't revolve around telling people all of the blessings that happen to you. Some of them said it means to convey Islam to people, i.e. to tell people about the blessing of Islam. But this idea that you need to tell everybody everything good that happens to you, this is not actually, really doesn't have an evidence for it in Islam. We still need to keep ties with people, even if those family members are people who dislike you doing well. However, we need to give an example of how you can keep ties with these family members while still not necessarily telling them all of the good that happens to you. So for example, you moved to a new house and you're in the habit of keeping ties with this particular relative over the phone. And on a phone call, the relative says to you, you know, how are things with the new house? So you have two choices. You can either, you know, sort of pour out all of the blessings of Allah. Alhamdulillah, it's amazing. We got it so cheaply and without any debt. And alhamdulillah, it's the most amazing place. I've never seen anything like it. And then you know that that person doesn't like seeing other people do well and is going to harbor some enmity and hatred for you. Or you can simply play it down without rejecting the blessing of Allah. Say, alhamdulillah, it's okay. Alhamdulillah, everything's going all right. There's a big difference. And we're not saying, oh, it's terrible. We're not saying to lie and say, oh, it's terrible. It's the worst place ever. It's nothing special. But just keep it with generic words that praise Allah. Say, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. We praise Allah in every situation. What an excellent answer that is. Just to say, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. We praise Allah in every situation. The person might get the impression that things are not going well for you. Alhamdulillah. You know, things are all right. Alhamdulillah. We're quite happy. Alhamdulillah. Without necessarily overdoing it. And one of the things we see is, for example, Facebook, social media, things like that, Instagram. These are key examples of how people bring this problem upon themselves by posting everything good that happens to them and even exaggerating the good that happens to them. And then their relatives who don't have a little bit of jealousy or a little bit of enmity in their heart, they cause harm to that person, because the person is literally embellishing and showing off everything that happens to them. What you have to do is to praise Allah Azza wa Jal for the good that happens to you, to thank Allah Azza wa Jal, to use what you've been given for good. But as for needing to tell every single person about it, we don't know of any evidence that indicates this in Islam. And as we said, the ayah, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ, it isn't acceptable as an evidence for this. Rather, what we think is the person should use generic words, praise Allah Azza wa Jal, and simply move on. Now, it can be more difficult because sometimes that relative wants to probe. Oh, okay, so how much did you buy it for then? And it becomes hard for the person, right? The person sees, oh, you know, if I tell them I bought it and I got it really cheap, then they're going to feel jealous of me. So again, you just try to use generic words, change the subject, get out of the conversation, or just, you know, just to say, you know, alhamdulillah, it was okay. We were happy with it at the end of the day. And just generic words. And obviously to seek refuge with Allah Azza wa Jal from the evil eye and so on. But there's a difference between that and between embellishing it and say, yeah, we got it so cheap. We've never had it so cheap. No one's ever. It's the most amazing thing. It was a karama from Allah Azza wa Jal that we got it like that. There's a difference between those two ways. So keep it generic and try to bring the conversation back to them and try to also set the limits that you don't want to overly talk about your personal situation, and just, you know, try not to get into those details like that. And Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.